Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the world of me. My name's Cougar. This is another episode from the Amazon review series. I'll add this into the camping and survival series too, because I've got another product in today. And as you can see, I'm not in the usual place, but you will understand why in just a minute. I came in this little bag here, so let's go ahead and open it up. Now, first thing we'll see is this is really nice. It came in a really nice oval case like this. Just zips around, and let's see what's inside the thing here. Okay, everything is put together inside the safety stuff here. All right, so we got a handful of things. I know this is difficult to see a little bit, but you know, we'll get into it. All right, first thing we have got a car charger with two USB ports on it, as well as a charging cable that uses the micro USB. We also have a handful of little pieces here, little clamps and things like that. And then we get into the main piece here. We've got the battery pack, the head straps, and then the light itself, which is a pretty boss looking light, honestly. It has the cable that goes from the back, so you've got kind of a little balancing act here. The light will hang down, the battery will hang down on the back, so you won't get pulled forward or backward by either one of the weights. They should kind of balance each other out. I think the battery's a little bit heavier, but I think that'll be all right. Let's see, we've got the power button right there in the middle, and we've got little charging lights right there. So comes with three of those. These should be the 18650 batteries here, and they do have the plastic on it, so we'll take that off. And as you can see, this is the company. You know, we've dealt with them before. That's Vast Fire Light, or just Vast Fire. Go ahead and get this all set up, and we'll go ahead and try out this light. All right, so I got all these out of the plastic. Just snap them all down. They all face the same way. And this is just a little simple clip-on. So it just snaps right like that. So open it up, flip it out like that. Now you've got the connection on the back end here. And there's your USB connector there. And you plug in. And this is cool because you can see here there's two. So you got the small one to charge it with, but you got the big one, so you can use this as a charger as well. The last flashlight that I got from these guys had the same thing, and I think that's a great idea. Let's see if we got, oh, look at that. Lights come on, shows that it's has a 3-bar charge, so it needs a little bit of a charge. But the cool thing is this is set up so that you can use this as a headlamp for when you're riding your bicycle at night. So you see that? You've got that flashing in the back, and people can see that when you're riding a bike or when you're jogging or anything like that, honestly. But if you're out at night traveling, you know, on foot or outside of a vehicle, you've got this to kind of give you some safety. And just turn it off with a single click. And then, let's see, we should have, there is the light turn on right here for the front. And with this, we do have the in and out, so it will focus. And of course, this is one of those very large, I believe, square Cree LED bulbs. You can see some of the light right now. Let's go ahead over into the field. It's got the flashing and different ones. Yeah, let's go ahead over into the field there, and we'll get a better look at this and see the kind of range that it's got. All right, guys, so we're in the field. This is actually the same field I was in for my last light that I got. I've got this here, so click on here. Again, we've got the flashing red lights there to let anybody behind us know what it looks like. We'll just hit that. And it's just an on-off. There's no special function of that. It's just going to be a flashing red light. And then again, we've got just a little flash at the, or the little push button at the top here. It's right there. You can see the silver part. It's right in the middle. And you can see this lights up really nice. Now again, I'm standing in This is supposed to be a softball field, but obviously it hasn't been used, didn't get used all last year because of COVID. So it's kind of overgrown, but you can see how much of this field it's lighting up. See, there's first base right there. So if we go first base, we're gonna go over to home plate. So let's see what it looks like. Looks like they cleaned it up a little bit. Home plate would be right there. They don't have it put in right now, but this would be home plate right here. And you can see that right there is the pitcher's mound. This is holding it out just in front of me right here. And you can see that spread. It's lighting up nearly the entire infield from home plate. And that's really nice. And then we can take and focus it down. Look at that. Focused right onto home plate. I can see easily. I can see second base directly behind it. And then this is shining. You should be able to see that. Yeah, there you go. There's the trees that are over there. Those trees are roughly 100 yards away from where I'm at. That is well beyond the standard distance for the outfield for this field. Of course, across this whole section here, if we go from this area all the way over to the area over there, that is a soccer field, kind of a generic one. Super, super bright. Everything is getting lit up. You can see, there you go. You can see those trees. Those trees are on the other side of the road, on the other end of that field, which puts them at roughly about 120 yards away from where I'm at, and it's lighting them up. Now, of course, on your end, it's a little darker. On my end, it's lighting them up really well. So we've got a ton of light here. This would be terrific for anybody that's gonna be going out. If you're gonna be going out and riding or walking outside or anything like that, hiking, anything like that, this would be terrific for that, I think. Of course, this is an aluminum housing, so it is the very durable stuff, just like any of the other stuff that Vasfire's put out there. I've been very impressed, and I've noticed as time goes on, they seem to come out with much better stuff. Better quality, higher brightness, all that kind of stuff. So I'm becoming more and more impressed with each one of their products that I get. All right, now along with this, something else, you have that the button, and just like any of their other flashlights, this does have multiple settings. So what we're looking at has been the high beam, or the brightest setting. If we hit it again, you can see it does go down. Unfortunately, it seems to kind of cause it to flash on the screen. Sorry for that. But it still lights things up really, really well. I would probably, honestly, I would be fine with leaving it just like this. This would actually be more than adequate for in town, kind of traveling around, especially if there's any types of street lamps or anything nearby. And then of course, for the third one, it has the flashing. And this is a slow flashing. That is because this is more for traveling and stuff like that. This isn't for self-defense where the super flash blinking is needed to kind of blind an attacker. This is more of catch your attention kind of thing, just like the flashing on the back of the battery there. The other thing is if you can kind of see this, try and do it, but I'm holding it up straight and I can tilt it so you can angle it as you need to, and it just kind of snaps into place. So it shines like straight forward, and then it can angle down, and it goes clear to about, yep, we're looking at about 90 degrees. If you can kind of see that, there we go. 90 degrees straight down. If you guys want to check this out, you can go down there in the description below. There is, of course, going to be a link to this on the Amazon page. Obviously, while you're down there, don't forget to check out the social media links. There's also the PayPal link if you want to help out the channel. I definitely appreciate that. And don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so. And that little bell so you know when I've got new videos coming out here on World of Me. That's going to do it for me today. Again, my name's Cougar. This is World of Me, another episode from the Amazon Review Series. Like I said, I'll throw this in with the camping and survival series. And I'd like to wish you guys all a good day, and I will see you later. Bye.